Hello everyone, welcome to Sgt-Maj Smoke. My channel is about barbecue, food, cooking, and of course, eating. I'm not a professional, just a regular guy with a passion for food and cooking. For those that are new to my channel, if you enjoy the content, please like and subscribe, and make sure to hit that notification bell to get notified every time I drop a new video. As for those returning, thank you, and it's good to see you back again. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below, as I will read and respond to them all. And now, for today's episode. Hello everyone, welcome to today's episode 009. We're going to do a veggie stew, and I got the recipe from Ross Kitchen. So big shout out to them, hopefully you enjoy. I don't have one of those automatic spirits, so I defuse the old school barbecue lighter. Works fantastic. I just want to say there's many things you can do in a barbecue. As you can see, it's kind of rainy. Not the best weather, but it doesn't mean I can't barbecue. In fact, I barbecued breakfast this morning on my griddle. Take my Dutch oven. Doesn't necessarily have to be for coals. It works fantastic on the flame. I'm gonna make myself a little bit of a Jamaican stew. All I got in here is a bit of celery, a bit of onions, and a bit of extra virgin olive oil. This is a hybrid of a recipe I got from at Ross Kitchen. I gotta give a shout out to them because I really like their channel. I like the fact they cook over open fire. So we're just gonna jump in and out of this. All I'm gonna do right now is just saute these up. Get them nice and soft. Before I start adding the rest of the stuff with the soup slash stew. Welcome back.
There are many facets to barbecue.
An open flame, propane gas, or natural gas, there's nothing wrong with that either, as far as I'm concerned. So as you can see, a little worn. I don't know if you can see that from this angle, but pretty much around medium heat. So the cast iron works wonderful. I love this Dutch oven. This actually isn't that old. And I've used it a few times and I love it. Oh, a little bit of steam there. Sorry, folks. Again, I'm just stirring it up. Then saute it a bit. I don't want to burn it. I just want to fry it up a bit. Smoke. Nice and easy. Stir it up. This is just the way I like to do it. I always like to fry up my onions, and if I got mushrooms or green peppers and celery, I like to fry them up. Okay, I'll take these a bit more for sure before I add any other veggies. For my Jamaican vegetable stew, soup. Okay, we're back. As you can see, they're browning up. So it's time to add the remainder of the veggies. So I have some sweet potato, some turnip, I have some pumpkin, carrots. That's all the harder veggies. It'll take a little longer, so I'm going to put them on first.
You can see
I added the carrots, turnip, pumpkin, and sweet potato. Put that back up to around a medium heat. Bring it to a boil, then I'll cover it. Let it simmer, let some of the water level go down before I add the remainder of the veg. And of course, the coconut milk. We'll be back. So it's only been on 10 minutes. I use this handy dandy lifter because, well, I don't want to burn my hands all off. Again, going back to Ross Kitchen, I'm at Moco. Gonna make sense. Safety first. Don't drip any hot liquid on me. And you see, it's boiling up nicely. Nice little stir, and just let it boil. I don't want it to become mush, I want them to become cooked. The remaining ingredients I'm going to be adding are some beans, canned beans in this case, potatoes, some yellow beans, because they don't take a long time compared to a hard turnip, pumpkin, or a carrot.
So again, let that boil so they're almost cooked. Then I'll add my next group of veg. Hopefully I can get some of the water level down as well. See in a bit. Just boiling along nicely. Again, not ready yet, but it's coming. For flavor, heavy coconut flavor with the coconut milk. I'll explain that when we get to that part. I'm also going to add some chicken soup base, which I'll show, and a little bit of sriracha, because I like hot. Add a little kick to it. That's all I wanted to show you for now. We'll be back. Well, welcome back. So here you are. The veggies and stew are coming pretty good. Now it's time to add some more. Again, potatoes, some yellow beans, and some lava beans, I think it's called. Doesn't really matter what type of bean. It's a bean-based soup, to a degree. But a very good vegetarian meal. Made on the barbecue. And it'll have lots of flavor. Incorporate that in. Put the lid on. Let her cook up. Once it gets partially cooked, then I'll add the chicken soup base. See you in a bit. Welcome back. It's come along nicely. Gonna add my chicken stock. Usually a couple spoons full or so. It's a guide. It'll all mix in. Add a little bit more. Mix it up nice. If you can smell it. Really, besides a little bit of sriracha sauce and a little bit of this chicken soup stock, there's not a lot of stuff added for flavor, but it's, quote, Triple D, an old guy, Guy Fiero, flavor town, for sure. I'm gonna let that boil some more, lid off it, hopefully get the water down some more, then add some coconut water. That's it for now. Let's have a look, everyone. Look at that. Again, flavor town. Gonna add some coconut water here. So I took some fresh coconut, I grated it, and then I squeezed the snot out of her and get all the nice coconut flavor, homemade coconut milk. There we go. We're just going to let this boil, let it stir up. It's going to make a mess. That's just the way it is, and that's a great thing about barbecuing. Look at my cast iron. It's coming along quite nicely. Let's let it boil, and I'll probably turn the temperature down. Turn it down just a little bit. Let it boil a bit with the cover off, and then put the lid on. Okay, everyone. Well, I've let it sit for a little bit. I turn the heat off. Oh, look at that. Now I'm just going to bring it back up to temperature. Basically boil, let it cool a little, and then time for eating. Beautiful, thick stew.
Okay, everyone. Thank you for watching my video. Hopefully you enjoyed the veggie soup slash stew. It's pretty thick. I will show more detail next time with regards to the coconut milk. It is quite the process, but it really is a flavor enhancer. Again, a big thanks and shout out to Ras Kitchen. If you did like the video, please like and subscribe. If you have any comments or questions, please don't hesitate to leave them below. Until next time, this is Sgt-Maj Smoke.